So the school has voted.
So the school of the year Yotv fan award goes to Nationwide Academy.
Nationwide, what's your favorite thing there?
Nationwide is the best, and it's the best school.
It's the best school.
Done.
Okay, and could you speak about your school as a record school?
We thank you so much for voting for us. It's Nationwide, where your school that prides itself in excellence. And these are some of the things that we brought here for excellence, and we are hoping to propagate them right across South Africa, so that, you know, we foster that discipline, determination, and diligence among its learners.
Nice.
So
thank you.
Amazing words, and the school has been voted and actually given the award for the best school. So all over the country, Bloemfontein, Mpumalanga, make sure that you too communicate to us, and you might just win yourself this award.
That's true, man. Now this is the only category.
They used to tell me
one man could change the world. That one man could change the world.
Tell me.
July is Madiba month, and we are doing our bit with the Yotv Book Drive. This time we are at Nationwide School for Academic Excellence. Look and gift with this, so let's see what happened.
What's up, everybody? It's an awesome morning here in the Johannesburg CBD. Myself and Gift are heading out to the Nationwide Academy because we've got a very special project.
Exactly. We are part of the Book Drive Initiative, which means we get to hope that it will sharpen their minds and they will get to read.
Yeah, I picked in the box with some Shakespeare and a couple of novels, as I'm hoping that this high school is going to enjoy all the goodies that we have for them. Let's check out all the answers that we've got right here.
I look back, yeah.
Thank you so much for having us at your school. We're living in 2015 and your life is not determined by your surroundings.
But you shouldn't let the next person define you. It's called self-esteem for a reason. Esteem yako, yako. No one can build it for you. It's mind over matter. What you think will happen. So believe in yourself. That's all I'm going to ask from you.
As teenagers, we tend to judge ourselves and compare ourselves to other people. And that's mistake number one. So thank you for hosting us. These are all yours. And I hope you guys enjoy them. We say we are very grateful to Yotv for this opportunity. The greatest present on earth is to teach a person how to get it by himself. And the only way we can get it by ourselves is to read. And that is the greatest present we got from Yotv.
The Yotv presenters were hanging out with the students. There was a question and answer session, and of course, a young motivational talk. Well done, boys!
What an awesome morning we've had. I'm hoping to have plenty more at the schools across the country. Maybe we're coming to a school close to you, so keep it locked.
Yesterday was history. history. Today is a gift, hence it's called a present. So take every day as a gift and believe that I may not be there, but I'm a step closer than I was yesterday.
Hala hala Yotv, I hope you are inspired to go out there and give back to the community. Goodbye!
So last week, the Yotv team hung out at the Nationwide School of Academic Excellence, where we conducted the first of our learner integration workshops, which seek to foster a harmonious and enjoyable school environment for high school learners.
And right now we are chilling with two members rather from Nationwide School, as well as the Kiki Mzansi Marimba. Here we go. Alright, so this side, Kanale Andile, Kanale Luande, Kanale Happy Munisi and Tabo. Welcome to you guys. Let's speak to Andile. Andile, Ujwensa, when I was about Nation Ready, and when you excel very well in school, right? So, Ujwensa, exactly.
Very good at life science, physics, and maths and history.
Wow. That's... So tell me, when did you realize that you are good in these things? Kids are how?
I think I was born with
that. Okay. So ever since Greek one, you've been slaying.
Yeah.
Like top achiever ever since. Huh? That's nice.
I want to ask you, did you find out that you're good in terms of it was a natural gift? Mm-hmm. Or did you love the subject first before you realized that, oh, I'm actually good at this?
I love the subject first.
Well, yeah.
And I'm trying to kill it for the last year.
Yes. For the last year. All right, how well, Elie, Lili, Luande, you want to speak all the way from, you're actually from Smile. So, as a Mzansi, Marimba group, it's a little smile, you know. So, enjoy it. And when are you going to learn Marimba?
Yo, I started playing Marimba when I was about 9 years old.
9 years old. So, tell me, when did you realize that you actually, instead of playing ball, guitar, or piano, why would you choose Marimba?
I choose marimba because I want to become a person
who plays marimba. Okay, that's nice.
Yes, that's so odd, but it's very unique as well, because a lot of people would like, what did that inform the thing? I want to play piano.
Yeah.
Piano guitar. Let's throw it to Andile just for one question before I'm like, Andile, you play cricket, right?
Yeah.
Do you have like any aspirations of playing for like the Frontiers?
Yes, okay. I do.
You do? Okay. You know what? I want to ask you a lot of questions when you come back regarding that. So I think you're like half and I'm gonna go
back. Blue couch, back go from karate to singing.
Real quick, extraordinary.
He is though.
Well, this is something about the Tabo. You have these certificates now, and the awards. Are you still motivated each time you play a cricket match to do your best?
Yeah, I still do.
So it hasn't changed anything.
It hasn't changed anything.
Wow, I love that.
That's nice.
I love it because sometimes when people get awarded for things, it goes to the head.
Yeah.
It goes to the head and then they're just like, I'm so great, you know, whatever.
Way very forward.
Exactly.
Yeah, but let's quickly speak to Mingis.
Okay, there's something that they're talking about on Blue Couch about practicing and, you know, continuing. Even though you're great at something, you continue to practice. I'll go to you, Tabo. There's something called the 10,000 hour rule. I don't know if you know about that. And I really want to pledge everybody that has a talent to use the 10,000 hour rule. It basically says that from the age of 5, when you discover that you have a talent, whether it's singing, playing piano, or doing whatever, you practice from that day, from 5 years old, each and every day until you master it.
10,000, well, why is it 10,000?
10,000 hour rules is equivalent to someone who by the age of 25, they become a pro, or even 21. That's why nowadays, we have people so young as 9, that are like on idols or whatever, because they started practicing.
When they were young.
Yes, so I want to urge you guys, so I want to ask you, how many times do you practice?
I practice every day. I'm just joking, guys. At some point, I'll break with you guys after this. Welcome back! one, today we are talking about those people got laughing about like 90% all the time, the whole time. And right now we've got Azuki all the way from Nationwide School. We're not going to get today. So I know I'm just out actually we're now over almost everything when it comes to academics.
Yeah, almost everything.
So tell me, clearly you before like almost all of them, which one is like the most difficult to like, you know?
Okay, accounting for me.
It needs extra hard work, how
Yeah, but then the rest, yeah, I'm cool with it.
And then what's like your best subject? Like no one, like when you sleep in, you can, I can ask you something about it and you already know the answer.
Oh, English.
English, yes. So what's my brushes?
Yeah.
Brushes is your,
when I was born.
When you were born? Yeah. Is that even possible? What would you even matter when you were born? You already know that soccer is your thing. Okay, that's very nice. And then come on now, how are you, sir?
I'm good.
You got Joel right here. So you play rugby. I can see what like, So tell me, when did you start playing rugby?
I started playing rugby high school.
In high school, yeah?
Great. Everything started from there. I started coming at the best day in the school.
Wow.
So I decided to stay with it.
Okay, so then now when did you realize that actually this is my thing? Like did you know that like rugby I'm gonna go play when I get to high school, or it just happened by accident?
No, actually when I was still young, I went to the game that physical, like good content. So when I got to high school there was rugby.
Like let me try it out, and you're actually good at it. Alright, that's nice. Last thing, I'm not gonna let you know, John, for that was.
I'm good at you.
Akishapu, so you're not just a maiden. What are you excelling?
Obviously, you can see I'm a top genius.
Obviously, I'm so sorry. What are you excelling?
Academics.
Academics, alright, so you and Matric right now, what's your favorite subject?
It has to be accounting.
It has to be accounting. Maybe you guys can help each other.
Yeah.
So tell me, what do you think is so different about you compared to somebody at 24, 25, 25?
Because I'm a go-getter.
Yeah.
And that's what matters.
And then how many times do you practice, like, when you're studying, how many times do you study and stuff?
Every day. You have to study every day when you want to achieve better things.
All right. It seems like these people, you know, in order to be the best at what you do, you need to do it every single day. There you go, everybody. Let us know what you think and what you're good at. It's Yotv Live on Twitter and on Facebook. We go by Yotv. Right now, let's go back to Blue Calm. Thank you, Jess. Thank you so much, Blue. We are loving Blue Calm today. Now, guys, it's all about extra talented people in general, like our audience members. We have them students. So we got a tweet right here from Bonita Samile. It's Tabelo Mabona, the real underscore Miss T. And I'm talented in acting and presenting. In brackets, public speaking and debating. Camera is my best team. Camera to my guest for this into my
Make your way, send that email.
Alright guys, I want to know if you guys weren't doing, we have new guests right now. I'm still talking about talents there. If you had to do anything, like I want to know from you, when are we doing what you've been in all the subjects, right? So what are you going to be doing in varsity then?
I want to do business management.
That's what you love the most.
Yes.
All right. Because thing is, you know, sometimes, you know, how about everything?
They get confused.
Then it's choosing which field to go in.
That's true. I want to ask you about my, you play netball. If I'm a bellman, you play netball and athletics.
Which one do you love the most? Athletics.
So that's like running. Sprints and stuff like that, or long distance?
No, I don't sprint. Only do long distance and long distances.
Also, have you ever gone into like trials? You run against like regions or like national teams or provincials?
Yes.
You great. That's
I can see. I even run through over the.
Yeah.
And actually, during the ad break, we're having a little conversation here with Valma. Valma actually participated in what is known as IAAF. So she participated on an international level. With Bobo's Mukata, and not with against them, no, but in the kind of category and the kind of. That is actually so big. Then congratulations. So as we can see, Valma, what I said. Now I want to ask you this. Do you want to take your talent further than what it is right now? So, about the Tamika instrument, beyond this, or is it just something you do as a recreational thing?
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah, my photo is answered.
So, like a high school, to matric, after matric, you want to do a little bit of it.
Yeah. Like we could like each game living so like but Utamika still comes to Kali, so give us a whole lot of
okay.
So as your band, do you guys go into competitions or do you guys perform fella for bands with like a concert type of thing?
Yeah, we have a competition and also play a good performance.
An important thing is that we're
talking about hey, can I
I'm living by you know what, man? I think I'm gonna be honest with those students out there who are not like on top of. I was never that student. Or,
and it's okay.
It's okay. We're gonna get a drink tea. It's okay.
As long as you have other things that you do, yes. You shouldn't limit yourself to academic excellence. You shouldn't limit yourself to sports excellence. As long as something, some people have things outside. Like when I was 18, you know, you can't excel in that high school. But you know what? I don't feel Papa. I'm gonna work on a book to couch.
What a beautiful episode of Blue Couch. We learned so much about it, but you know what I realized? At the end of the day, you need to love what you do.
Yes.
And as well as a child, you know, did like all fail about it. Did like all fail. How about the Vina Vina? How about the Jaiva? How about the Xagai Kantin? Do it because you're so young and when they are, as long as we're not only determined, you can do it all.
And also, when you're young, that's the moment where you grasp things.
Yeah, easy.
Yeah. You know, so that's why I think where the love comes. And actually, talking about being very young. We have Fernanda here,
yeah.
And she is 10 years old.
We are cool.
Yes, Lalubana. Fernanda, how are you? Who's making most of this? How are you?
I am fine.
You're fine. How did you know you could sing?
Why do you like singing?
Because I like to sing with my voice.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's nice. Okay. So, other different types of people, like which artists do you love? What are artists you think go in South Africa? Uthanda bani, live zant.
Uthanda uNyiko.
Okay, uNyiko. Nyiko's like, I guess presents on your TV one. Oh, yeah. Okay, on that note, cheers to that break, Mamo. I'll give you some break food.
What else can I do? Top of my paper, making sure the environment is clean, switching off the lights after everything, cooking, you know, girls, those are
nice, yeah, you know.
Yeah.
You know.
We can save the environment by reducing and by stopping the cutting down of trees and again we can educate people about saving the environment and actually like there are a lot of things to save the environment.
Beautiful episode, learning so much about the environment. But I want to ask, you know, what are the advantages and disadvantages of taking care of our environment?
Okay, I would like to talk about the advantages of an environment, because in an environment where there are a variety of people and we're able to socialize, because we become social, cultural, and we learn people what they eat and what they do and how they wear their clothes. So that now it becomes an advantage, because now we get to know better.
But you know what, let's actually break it down and go to this thing, this environment thing, very quickly, ne? What is environment?
Oh, thank you for the opportunity.
Oh, yes, girl.
Oh, environment, the surroundings and the conditions where human beings and plants, animals live or operate.
So it basically, where we are right now is an environment. So what surrounds you is an environment. Right now, guys, it's time for a quick commercial break. We'll be back. Stay right there in our environment, yo.
Yotv, you are still tuned into Yotv. And when I'm living in the Mountain View, the nationwide.
Hello, it's for house today.
Hey,
hey. We are talking about personality types. There's a whole lot of different personalities. And right now, my personality is who I am, and my attitude depends on who you are.
Yes.
How about that?
Yes.
Sometimes it's orange, sometimes it's gray or gray. What did you say?
But here's a question that I have. Seen like we're talking about personalities that clash. Can you bring the mic this way? I want to ask a perfect question.
Make it.
There we go. So what is flow and other things? My child is who's gonna govern our group? Perfect.
Yeah.
What a cool name. But anyway, so what presents that do you have?
I think
you're the observer. So in a group of friends, is there one person that you feel like we're clashing, and but it's just a situation, so I'm just gonna be your friend.
In the group of friends, I think there's someone that we clash together. At least I'm just going, there are some people who like, if you just talk to them, the person won't welcome. So you must first observe the person.
And because this topic is so hard, I'm going to be talking a little bit. So I'm trying to skip the saga, then my kids and the couch and the blue. Do my longer.
Hello.
Chris is still alive. Yes, we're going to be talking a little later on. So we want to know from you.
There
we go. So that time where we prepare for the choir practice. where we have our friends here. We're talking to our fella. How about? Okay, they're not ready. I can see clearly. But maybe it's because they got their minds locked on the topic that we have in hand. Namtanje. And obviously, we need to get an expert to come and talk to us about this. So how about that? I'm going to look at some soup to somewhere more. Get another Johnson, and he's actually a master youth coach and a young adult coach. I actually need to know how you got that title and what it actually means. And obviously our friends who are matching with that food couch, obviously. So a question, as I mentioned, the title, master youth coach. What does that bring? What kind of responsibility behind that?
And I'm going to back to the show. You asked to listen. Yo, CBS. Today the topic is he or she into you, and how do you know that? And here are some tweets actually that we've received from you guys. One is from Karabo Matembo, and she says, in order for me to know if he's into me, it's very simple. He needs to come and tell me so. That is very direct and to the point. And we have another one that's actually as similar as you guys have said earlier on. This is from Oba Derek Ligai, and he says, actions speak louder than words. So there's no sub-tweeting. These people are not, they don't want sub-tweets. They don't want
you're gonna send a letter.
Send a letter, or somebody tell somebody, just come and tell me.
Exactly. But you know, with that said, I mean, actions do speak louder than words, right, Ronaldo? But I mean, and there we are. Got it from the experts, talking about phone exchanging and getting the parents involved. Hey, that whole phone thing. But my mom still hasn't answered my question. When someone buys you a gift and without better, is it the same thing or is it?
Okay, I thought about it.
Okay.
It's two different things.
Yes.
A gift is something, something like you. A gift is me saying, this is a showing of appreciation.
Okay.
And how better, it's you having other intentions. So a gift is, this is how I see
it. Okay, so it's similar to like saying a compliment.
Yes.
A compliment because he's just being nice, or a compliment
because he's nice? Better, it means your intentions are to pursue something else.
Okay, so let's pursue the game we have in mind. So on the couch that we have to play, and it's very, very interesting.
You guys know how to play the game, right? Okay, here's the first one. I don't give you gifts.
It's not in tune,
man. I don't give you gifts. Oh, at the back there, I'm
seeing you. Who?
Can you take a
picture? Okay,
can
yeah.
The back there.
Yeah, the back there. Wow.
You know, yes.
Most times when you give gifts, it's when like you really want to give a gift. You don't just buy it just to prove the point to someone.
Yes.
And then at times when you just buy a gift just to make peace with that person to show that I can also buy you a gift.
Oh.
Right, good tip, man.
Okay, here's the second
one. Okay, here's the second one. I laugh at you with my friends.
Okay, that's a no.
Okay, here's the right. I dump you because you don't want to sleep with me.
That's a very deep one.
That's a bad thing.
Yeah.
Okay, here's another one. I spend more time on my talents than with you. I spend time.
Okay.
Here's another.
Okay.
Very quickly.
I think in terms of developing your talents, it's important as well. You know, because this is your future you're talking about.
Yes.
As teens, you're still going through a phase where you're going to date a lot. And the question is the dating going to get me to where I want to be? Or is my talents going to take me to where I want to be? So that's why I said...
Yeah. Yes.
Exactly.
Okay. But yeah, you just
spend
5 minutes.
Yes, I'm not saying it's
more
than a relationship.
Oh, okay. Okay, just checking.
I can say but you know what, guys? What we should remember is that a friendship and a relationship are almost the exact same thing. It's just the intimacy is just completely different. So if you keep that in mind, you will know why this question was a But right, for now, here's a yebo yes for an ad break. And this has been one of the most fun conversations that we had. And you know what? Thank you, Lumpen, just for that. Because it engages not just us, it engages our friends from our high school level. So, you know what? Two last questions of the game, right? I spend more time with my friends than I do with you.
Okay, so it's okay to spend more time with your friends than that person that is in here. Really? Okay, why do you say that?
Because I think it's more fun being with my friend than with him.
Oh!
Oh! Relationship! Did Hillary disagree with that?
Yes.
Disagree with her because we all like attention. I would want my man to tell me something that my friends won't tell me. My friends know.
Okay, last question.
I don't want to know, I want you to know about my whereabouts.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I knew that. What is the most common mistakes that you come across in relationships?
I think, in terms of relationships, the biggest thing for me is actually understanding who you are. You know, in the ad break, listening to some of the conversations, one of the things, or even before that, was a matter of saying, I need him to tell me things my friends don't tell me.
Yes.
And if you're going to get into a relationship because you need someone to tell you how awesome you are, when that relationship ends, your state goes into, I'm worthless, I'm useless, I can't do, because now there's no one to tell me who I am. Biggest mistake is find out who you are and not need someone. Not need someone to fulfill a need, but I want to be in a relationship because I like spending time with you. Not because you make me feel better, not because you give me money. Because that, over time,
the whole list,
over time, you find a way to fulfill the need. So we get into a relationship.
Okay. Thank you very much. I needed Mamu to make this show very beautiful.
Exactly. Thank you guys for coming so much, and thank you, Rana, for coming.
Pleasure.
Thank you guys for tuning in. You know what? And here's my message for you: be self-propelled and be self-complete. Do not put someone in your life to complete you, as you just said. Yep. So, friend or relationship, they must all be the same. But you know what? I can go on and on. We'll see you guys tomorrow. It is Giving Wednesday. It's gonna be amazing. Yes. And here is something for you. You know, like a title poem. Be being so bad. What?
Yes, babe. Like a titan ball. Beautiful. Hey, Todd.
Of a bow from the Kalahari Desert used by the Sand People.
Okay.
Bow has got so much history, I don't want to go into it, but I've got beautiful stories to tell about the bow and the music they make and how they get honey from the beehive by playing the mouth bow. That's a whole new episode, you know, but the bow is the indigenous instrument of the Kalahari Desert, of the Sand People. And as we know, the Sand People have been around for more than 45,000 years.
Wow.
They are our ancestors, you know. And then as we move on, we have the Kalimba.
The Kalimba, that's...
Which is the modern version.
Yeah. Did you show us a...
The Kalimba is a very modern version of the Imbira.
Okay.
Which come from Zimbabwe. The Imbira, the real name of the Imbira is called Imbira Zabatsimu. The spirit of our ancestors. Don't call it a thumb piano, because a lot of people call it, because people can't pronounce Imbira Zabatsimu.
I see Kimberly there's got the shaker.
She's got a shaker, which is a Brazilian kind of idea of adding rhythm.
Yeah.
But it's actually an African idea. Now these days, in the olden days, they used to have like calabashes and they put seeds in them and they would play them. But that one is just a very modern version and very easy to carry around in shape,
but it's here.
Like an egg.
Okay, we've got one more as well. I know you have.
And then that comes from the Native Americans, actually. It's a rain stick. It's called a rain stick.
Okay.
Makes the sound of water. And that was used and still used by different cultures for healing.
Ah, in the spirit?
You'd be lying down on your back and they would just play.
Yeah, it's kind of relaxation.
The rain stick over your head and sing and hum and chant over your body. The same with the other instruments. People use it to connect with the ancestral world.
So one really cool thing that Pops Muhammad actually did was that he taught our friends from Nationwide how to use some indigenous instruments, and I'm excited to hear what they played. Are you guys ready to show us what you've done?
Nationwide band.
Nationwide band. All right, so guys, let's hear it in 3, 2, 1, shuffle.
Yeah.
Can I please just say, it sounded like they were singing chilling.
chilling on the couch, chilling on the blue couch.
Well,
you wiki wong.
Why is it wiki wong?
No, let's do an experiment. You guys play. She must sing exactly what she's saying now.
Okay.
Let's do that. There's no pressure, Jess.
No pressure.
Hey, can look
chilling on the blue couch. That's a new song.
Alright, and then after that,
you'll get the publishing. You'll get the publishing.
And the royalties, let's go.
Yes, right. I go.
Chilling on the blue couch with my loonies.
Yeah, yeah.
And Pop Muhammad.
What effect does social media have on the way girls treat each other? So, I want to nickname Huri a you are the person who's typing all these things about other people, or me bitching, they're talking about you.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is what I'm saying.
Like you, think you love a feel like I am.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I'm a cool young man, maybe I wanna. I'm a full champion, so I'm a cool man, I wanna be a fine man.
So when they started fighting, then I told them, if you've got a problem with me, come to me. Don't tell me, because thing was not me, and I'm not going to solve the problem if I don't know what the problem is.
But so do you guys think that, you know, as women, do you think that if it's a bit over the world, any other WhatsApp, our Facebook, do you think that we have a relationship with each other?
Yeah.
Ladies,
Mandom,
Zani!
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 Sarah!
I love the possibility.
So I'm going to
question for you guys, man. So when girls are calling each other, you know, with those dirty words, how does that affect the way in which one thinks of themselves? So if somebody calls you that, what do you think of yourself? Like, oh, do you think it's okay? Do you think it's cool? Do you think it's dirty? How do you think about that?
Yeah, it depends. Like, sometimes, if to me, I'll go to the kind of know that, but then if I'm human, I'll go to the kind of look like,
You've seen this guy, and or even like with friends, you know, and they're spreading rumors about you, and there's this rumor that when now you had this girl, or they're like, oh, feeling they will have a thank you, red job, and then they release all these dirty words about you, then, and it's something that now the thing goes. So how do you handle those situations? Because sometimes it does happen with like.
Like I was clueless, one day I figured scholars and then people was not. With all that, I went to the source of them like, me now. I don't even know that. Even the real food, then you collab on me, and then things like, you know, they label you and. Mustn't feel the man said you would say me, vacuum cleaning, so many other parts of the year. Mustn't feel like that, because maybe the officer is giving me my part the whole day.
Without being stigmatized in that sense.
Anybody for a question?
Yeah.
Oh. I'm sharing the show.
Well, I think, yeah, they can be, because there's nothing wrong with them being a sport woman. It doesn't make any difference of who they are.
And also, I mean, definitely, we know of a lot of women. I mean,
Men are different than us, you know.
Do you know that there's, and compared to rugby, there's touch rugby.
Yeah,
and compared
touch rugby.
To wrestling, there's a different kind of wrestling.
So they just touch, they don't tackle.
Okay, here's the second one. Can a woman be a mother and a successful sportswoman?
Successful sportswoman.
Yes.
Does
anyone want to say why about men? Why about men? Petunia. Mike says, see?
Alright.
Can
you just repeat the question?
Okay.
Yeah, so, can they give birth and, you know, have families and still be successful women?
You agree to this.
Well, I do agree. I really don't think Uti, the boundaries, like, this is for men, this is for women.
Because now my daughter, like, they don't just play sports just like that. Uh-huh. Practice.
Yeah.
Now, I think women also need to practice to be like men. Mm-hmm. And I think they have to be recognized like men.
Yeah.
Got this.
All right, this is the last one quickly. Are male sports stars more popular than female sports stars?
Yeah, well, yeah.
Shan, why are you saying who hair? Quickly, but why would you wear?
Because I think female sports thing, it's not recognized the most, yeah. Because males are more recognized than females, yeah, in this.
Yeah, I think, you know what, everybody, you're absolutely right. It's all got to do with the PR and how these people have been put out into society. So that's why we are here, to make it known that all these women, all these phenomenal women are out here, and we are the mouthpiece, because we are the women, and we are the PR team for all those women in sport. Viva to your tiny Marabis. Viva to all those absolutely awesome women doing great things. Like this lady over here, I've been reading about her, Enoela Aluko. She plays for something, lady. She's awesome. She's awesome. She's awesome.
Okay, what's up, girls?
Hi.
Ooh, hey. Okay, cool. Tell me, I think because it's nice to assume that everyone has a dream, but it would be nice to hear what some of your dreams are. So, I don't know, is there anybody here who wants to do something big with their life one day?
Okay, can I go first?
Go first, go third, go together, and let's just talk.
Okay, about in 7 years' time, I want to see myself in the media industry. I want to be a TV and radio personality. I think I'll give Sowunzi or Bonang the run of their money.
All right.
So, like, I know that I have to study hard and work hard in order for me to go and study media and stuff.
Yeah.
From school first, then the big dreams after.
In 7 years' time, I would love to be an ambassador of a very big company, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so you want to do the marketing thing?
Yeah, so I'm going to study international relations, like, yeah.
Wow, okay,
and
cool.
I would also be in human resources, actually.
Okay, so the doors are just open.
Yeah.
You must just go in, see an internship. Okay, so now with all of your dreams, I mean, they sound so rich. With you as a girl, do you think that achieving your dreams possible?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot.
Why? Even if I told you, hey, I don't think you can do it.
I
mean, what if I've always dreamed of being a singer and then people tell me I can't sing?
No, there's no such thing.
There's no such thing.
Yeah,
there's no such
thing.
I think it's your self-esteem and self-development. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Any lesser. Like, when you're telling yourself, you know what, I want to do this, just put your mind and your effort and just go ahead and do it.
Don't mind what people are saying about it.
Okay, so now as a female, do you think that it's possible when you've got kids as well? And do you think you'll reach your dreams even though you have kids one day?
No, with kids, it's more easier.
Yeah. How does having a child make it easier to fulfill your dream?
Like, your brain now getting matured, like, you know what to do, you know, like, that you have that maturity in you.
Okay.
So you know that you have a family that you have to look after. So you put much effort in that thing that you want to do now, then it will be easier for you.
Even though this child is crying for you, where, mommy, mommy?
No, you have to make a plan as a woman.
The child is actually building your courage.
Yeah.
The child is building your courage.
Yes.
Okay, so now I want to go to a meeting, but I must go fetch my child from creche, and I tell my boss, no, I can't go because I must go to creche.
That's why you have to have a help.
There's nothing called time management, right? You can just work things out.
Play your cards as a
lady. Yeah. That's where you go.
Okay, cool. So on that note, girls, thank you so much for letting me know about what your biggest life aspirations are. And just to hear that we're on the same page, who runs the world?
Girls.
everyone's drinking.
On that note, you know, we've got reality TV, we've got magazines, we've got all these things, we've got movies. Have you ever looked at any of those things and then once it's finished and you see the credits roll, you think, what about my life? Do you think that sometimes it influences the way you see yourselves?
Yeah, sometimes it does. But it's just a fantasy. Like, I don't really believe in movies, but then at some point it really affects my life in a way. Like, saying, what's okay, that chick has got her stuff and everything, independent. Yeah, it also pushes me to, you know, working towards those. Yeah.
Even if you don't have a career choice, you'd be like, oh no, what if I become that girl? So let me also try. Then one day you just try, then you see your life much easier and you know that girl that you wish to be. Then
okay. So let me ask you this then. When you look at Beyonce's latest music video, then when you're watching her, how does it make you feel about yourself?
It inspires me a lot because I want to be like her.
Yeah, we are tired.
So Beyonce inspires, ne? Okay, so when you see, I'm not gonna bring Bonang into this because Queen Jesus. So when you look at Mini Dlamini, how does that make you feel?
I just like her because it's like the last week. I was watching her talking about her background and telling people how her life was when she was young. And yes, she turned the land on her. Like, it comes nice and just someone goes, how is she now? From the background that she grew up in, running away from school, going to the parties. Oh. But now, look how her life is.
So let me take this now to the boy side. Do you think that, you know, reality shows, music, and films and those things affect the way boys see us as girls?
Yeah,
how so?
They be intimidated. Like, they become scared of us. Like, oh my word. Now, like, we share a mean business.
So, you want to intimidate? Insecurities. Ew, are we angry?
So, do you think that those things only influence boys in a positive way? Is there a negative way as well?
Yeah, influence and confuse you. Negative, put your neck pause.
Okay, let me take it one step further. Let me bring up an example. Like, I don't know, the trend of yellow bones. Where do you think it came from?
On the guys.
What were the guys saying?
Most of the guys, you know, they'll be like, okay, I want myself a yellow bone, a girl with them curves and stuff. Then it influences us to start using those creams like Caroline, start bleaching your skin. Which is not really good for your skin.
Black is also beautiful.
Multitask a lot.
Multi-talented.
Yeah. Do you guys, as a young woman, what do you guys think you still, or what do you think you've overcome to be where you are now?
Like judgment. Judging. What I mean, very natural, you can see the memories. But I know some of the trendiest shoes ever. I wear this. Small shoes, not dress. One way.
Yes. I like the look. I think you're rocking it.
Oh, thank you. And I just don't judge. What I want to do, I don't feel it.
I'm going to judge me. So you feel that as a young woman, you've overcome judgment?
Yeah.
Okay. What have you overcome?
Yeah, I can take a point.
Okay. So you also skateboard as well?
Yeah, and you have one. Next.
Yeah, so have you overcome judgment then?
Yeah.
And from who? Who are these people?
You get the girls.
You get the girls.
You get the girls.
You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the girls. You get the gir
Yeah. Thing. Yeah. Quinji, don't be
Me respecting my principles, right? Like, as I am, I respect myself the way I am. I don't care whoever thinks about me or whatever you want to say about me. I'm just living my life the way it is. Yo, lover.
Yo, lover. Yes. What have you overcome?
Also judgment, also people are judging me, my height. Even if I tell them, guys, I'm 17, I'm in grade 11, they're like, oh, he's lying, you're very short for grade 11. I'm like, oh, guys, I'm in grade 11, I'm big. Even kids right now, small kids, my sisters, they're 14, 12, they're taller than me. Oh, wow, you're very short. How can you be our sis? No, I'm big. They're judging me, my height. I think I should grow tall and eat cucumber.
No, you shouldn't.
Okay, maybe I should also try this cucumber. Tell me something, if now you've heard that everybody's going through judgment, what would you say to someone who would judge other girls for nothing?
I would actually say that you mustn't judge, because when you judge, other people will also judge you, like, so it doesn't make sense judging other people, because you're also being judged.
I think this woman is perfect.
Yeah.
Okay.
If you judge out there, only a sign, you're crazy.
No,
and you know what, on that note, I think it's safe to say that, you know what, this is a no judgment zone.
Yeah.
You judge me, you're not worth it.
Yeah. Yeah. Of course.
No one is ever perfect, so.
Yeah. Cool. Okay, are there any beautiful ladies in the house?
Yeah!
Cool bananas. So I actually read recently about an article in Destiny magazine about how to this day, men are still earning more than women in a lot of spheres. So like in sports, in the entertainment industry, and just in like work in general. So I don't know, guys, is it fair?
No,
it's not. It's not.
Okay, but why do you think that is, and do you think that is true at all?
Girls beat boys at school. Girls beat boys in universities. But then when it comes to workplaces, then like guys are beating us girls.
Guys are more than men.
This thing is actually stereotyping, right? They still have this black mentality whereby, like, the woman must, like, they must always be in the kitchen and cooking for the husband, which is, like, it's not proper.
But what is the, so you're saying stereotyping is the one cause?
Yeah.
What is the other cause? Is there a perception that women aren't as smart as men, or yeah, where else does it come from?
Let me say, okay. Umfazi earns less than a guy. Uthole lo mfana lo akazinto ayenzayo uyaphuza nje yonke into chemical proof. You know, sometimes maybe we're reasonable. Naturally, we also have our priorities. We also have to take care of certain things. We also need our salaries now. I think that when I think to pay my
yeah. So then let me flip this another way. So in the corporate world or in any other industry where you're doing a profession, now let's take it to any place where now the woman's body is in question, or that's what she's using in the profession, and then now, because of that, she gets paid a lot of money. Let's take Kim Kardashian being paid to do a magazine cover or something. Are we only as worthy as our bodies are? I don't know if that makes sense to you. So meaning, as a woman, is my body more expensive than my mind?
No. Looks perish, bruh. You know, looks disappear. You age out. Like today, it's like one of those got those curves. You get babies with a little bit.
We are
beauty.
We need more brains.
Yes. Cool.
danger of alcohol abuse. And right now, it's finally Mahutsubaruna from Nationwide, which is welcoming right now. Let's talk to her, guys. Shabeli Shai, what's up? How? But I'm bringing the guys. You guys understand the danger of alcohol abuse, or do you guys even know what alcohol abuse is?
Alcohol is a bad thing because most of teenagers focus on alcohol not long during their school days and stuff.
Okay, would you want to tell
me? Also, when you drink alcohol, yeah, you become disobedient.
So, like, how am I being now? Yeah. So, do you think that goes along? Una lang ba naman mga tapos kasi sa mga
yes. Because most of them they bank school, so it means when they're banking school, they're going there out to drink all those things.
Yeah. And you're teenagers and you grow, and when they were just like peer pressure, you know, and some people they get pressured into doing certain things. How do you then? Because peer pressure is also a form of bullying. So how do you then, as a person in the world, you're amongst those people who are pressurizing you to drink alcohol, how do you control it and how do you say no and do you report it? You can answer.
On studying and doing other things, like good things.
Do you think, sometimes, like, listen, go higher, unali go mikiti, mama fuinging, and about to go malo ba, and everything, but no, uma something at Fiji. Do you think that actually contributes to how ba na batala unara
and kateng? I would say it really does contribute because, I'm in Kenya. As much as I like to skate in your zone, we don't get to it. But it's okay. So now my room and room right, and I'm like that. What am I going to do? If my room is doing it, then I want to try it. Why is it happening? Then I want to do it. Which is, it's bad.
It is definitely bad, and that's why I do love it. Under the age of 18, because obviously, like, we're not curious. But anyway, we're also curious, and we want to hear from the experts. Here's Blue Cloud. Welcome back to the show, everybody. It's Yotv Ratch on SABC1. This is the last segment of the show, and we have been talking about the dangers of alcohol abuse, and we're still chilling here with Karabo and Lungela, as well as the people, our friends from Nationwide. So guys, I asked you guys, about, let's say, Ujulali, an uncle or mom, dad, who abuses alcohol, how do you think it affects, the person who doesn't drink, or the person in the household?
Well, first, it affects the house, like, emotionally, because maybe you can be in a good mood with mom, you're laughing, then dad walks inside and he's drunk, and then he wants to start abusing you guys, hitting, and start saying bad words towards you, so it's really, like, kills the mood for everyone in the house.
And then any other comments, maybe one person, about how you are?
Well, to me, I see there's, like, parental responsibilities, because, like, you find yourself in a situation, okay, your father's one who's drinking, then like he comes home drunk, like me as a teenager, I say that, like, I look up to him, like, maybe like next day I'll be the one who's drunk.
That's very true. Another interesting question that came up while we were chatting, was that can you go to a party and not drink? Promoting an alcohol free life. Thank you so much, Nationwide School, for joining us. Lungelo, Karabo, thank you very much. Mary, Mother Mary, it's been great.
Yeah.
Tomorrow you can catch Karabo as well as Lungo at 3 o'clock. But guys, here is iPhone with Angelela. Everybody, bye bye. Mega Joseph Jason. Join ahead, we have our awesome guests in studio. Hello, ladies.
Hi.
How are you?
you define standing out?
Well, to me, standing out is something that you have and you, it's something unique that nobody else has.
Oh, do you fit in or do you stand out?
I fit in. Sometimes it depends on what the situation is.
Is it? Somebody tell me, when do you fit in or do you stand out?
I like standing out.
Okay, what makes you stand out?
I don't know. I guess it's the kind of person that I am. Yeah.
All right. And then, Jola, here, when up, do you also have friends who maybe fit in or try and be like other people and or in Hawaiian college?
You gotta be yourself, cause you're unique. You're special in your own way. So you gotta be unique. Don't try and be someone else. Just be yourself.
All right. Yeah. You just, hey guys, you have to stand out and do your own thing. So okay, we love hearing from you guys from our social media. So how about the whole question? Yeah, today, Irene. What makes you unique? Interact with us.
Subconscious mind, the great things, cause your subconscious mind is your partner in success. The second thing, right? We have self-actualization, self-love, and self-belief. You've got to believe in yourself, right? So when you know who you are and you love yourself, then you believe in yourself, right? When somebody tells you that you're beautiful, this surprises me. I've moved up chair with you, you're beautiful, and you're like, oh, thank you. Didn't you know that you're beautiful? So when somebody tells you that you're beautiful, it's like, but tell us something that you already know.
Yeah,
they're affirming something that you already know.
Yeah.
So you're not being arrogant, you're saying thank you so much, but apparently like saying, but I know that I'm beautiful, right? So when your self-actualization is right, and your self-love is right, and your self-belief is right, you get to the self-esteem, right?
Hey, Princy, how about you, Stacey? What's up, guys?
Hello.
How you doing?
Fine, Angel.
Good, thank you, Stacey. So cool. You see, like, I'm fine, actually. Holding your mug. Are you okay?
Mm-hmm.
Are you
all good?
Jenna, today we're speaking about culture, né? When you hear the word culture, what do you think about?
Culture is when many people are gathered together,
mm-hmm.
and people nowadays, they tend to be together with music, poems, books, because that's when they'll be reading, singing, listening, and all those things.
Yeah, so basically you're saying the word culture goes beyond traditions and things like that, you know?
Yeah.
Like culture, fashion, trendsetters, and things like that, né?
Oh.
Sharp, sharp. Prince, my prince. Where's your princess?
Ash's right
here. Right? Ah! Angel! So I don't want to prince, tell me, are you part of any cultural, do you have any cultures well in your school that have been started?
Yeah. Saturday. Mm-hmm. Because it's from 6 to 6, like 6 p.m. to 6 a.m.
So you've cultivated a culture of learning. And that is what GM is also all about, a culture of learning. Speaking about cultures right here, guys, we're giving you an opportunity to check out our poll question that later on Facebook. So let's check out what our poll question is here today. And why do you think young people in South Africa don't go to museums, art galleries, and theatres as opposed to chilling at the street corner? That's it. There's so much you can actually do. Thank you so much, guys, for joining us today, yeah?
Thank you
so much, Rufe. Now, before we go, Stacey, I know you have a very special talent, you know? You love singing. So, we're going to be in a fella before the Samaya.
Okay.
Hey, hi. Hurry.
Remember those walls I built? Well, baby, they are tumbling down. They didn't even put up a fight. They didn't even make a sound.
What?
I tried to find out what could let you win, but I never really had a doubt.
Okay.
Standing in the light of your halo, I got my angel now.
Thank you so much, Ivanta. Feeling it, it's get entertainment, not just education. Prince, why don't you tell me something?
I'm
not just talking talent. I'm not talking. We're not even mixing our own talent. Look, man, I'm not just talking talent. I'm talking about finding talent. I can't. Hello, Charlie, the hard day, you know.
Okay, so how are you guys doing?
So
good. We're great, man.
Social.
All right, I know what your name is, Opumzile, né? But tell me more about you.
Opumzile, you told us come with an abandon.
So you're happy when you're chilling with us, yeah? Alright,
yeah.
And then who are you with? What's your name? Why do you think we have a shortage of women in the sciences industry? Please, Bapetu, tell us, Jokuti, what is
your opinion, you can tell us on Facebook or on Twitter. Now, as I love to say, I know it's so early in the morning and your brain needs a little bit of waking, and that's why we've got the Brain Breaker. So the Brain Breaker for today is, which mountain is the highest mountain in the entire world? I know that the G and Clan mates at home know what it is. Marina, do you know? You just know. So, easy game.
The tall buildings behind me should give you a clue, because you're going to get zinted at pool. Still guessing where it is? We're in Johannesburg, yeah, downtown to be exact. Suskolin S. Biscuiti, a nationwide school about to play game yet. A Biscuiti Los Angeles A. Physical Sciences about galvanic cells. Are they spontaneous? Are not spontaneous? But to tell me, we'll hook you more up on that to find more details. Go back in studio. So, what we need to do right now is we're going to get a match. I need to enter the school and find out who will be playing for Team A and Team B, and see who'll be crowned the school champs for today. But without wasting any time, follow me singing this one, son of a bitch. Son of a bitch.
I'm a bitch.
When you turn to your call, I'm going to eat cheap.
I'm a chillaxer.
And it's actually a celebrity writing school. Like, as we're doing this, there are his classmates over there, and people are saying, please send me a shout out to someone. Come on, get Prince, okay?
Hey, hi. Paris, keep Paris.
Paris. Has he seen Paris before?
Yes. Yes. An anode.
So, okay, when I tell you, I was telling you,
Hello guys, my name is Tulozani. Shout out to my friends right there. Yeah, I'm from Nation Wild.
Hi guys, my name is Aisha Maya. At the Team A, we're gonna win because this group is full of geniuses.
Hello! Hello guys, Pelo Sizani. Shout out to my homies.
Hello!
Hey yo, my name is Noxy. Shout out to my classmates.
Hi guys, my name is Mfundo Nyandeni. Shout out to my classmates.
So now we've met Team A and Team B. What we need to do right now is introduce you to a game and a clutch, which you call Locks and Chains. As well as we'll see you.
Alright, Buffet, to win this game, Team A and Team B are asked the same question with only 30 seconds to give a correct answer. That's sure, Baba. Each correct answer will get them to move on to the next hula hoop, but it doesn't end there. With every correct answer a team gets, they get to tie up the opponent's legs or arms while the opponent sits on a chair. When they've gone through all of their hoops, they'll be given keys to unchain their own team member. The first team to unchain their team member wins the game.
Now that you've seen Guti give your teacher a rajan, I just want to find out who's taking it. Team A or Team B? Zatula. Okay, there's Team A, there's Team B, and the audience is
obvious. I don't know. What's obvious?
So, the first question is, what energy conversion occurs in a galvanic cell? To the Facebook is what you need to be hitting right now, @GN_SABC1, and on Facebook, see you can listen at right here in Nationwide High School, right here in Johannesburg. So, let us know how you're finding the games in your locks and chains, and who are you supporting? So, Hope, what is your answer?
Chemical energy to electrical energy.
Yo! Please show it to the camera. Hey, that electrical. Chemical in it. Okay, I can see the chemical in it. Then,
2. Hold it nice. What's this? It looks like a D.
I'm sorry.
Team B. What is the answer?
Electrical energy and chemical energy.
Electrical energy and chemical energy. Show it to the camera so the people at home can see. The correct answer is chemical energy to electrical energy. Okay, Team B is wrong because they said electrical energy and chemical instead of saying chemical energy to electrical energy. But I'll take this as your E. But next time, please, your handwriting on your home. Let's have home.
Okay.
So Team A is correct. What is happening right now is Uguti, who Aisha is going to lock Umfundo or Team B. So Aisha, as I said, Aisha is finally locked up Umfundo of Team B, and Team A was correct. So Hope, please stretch your way to the next two. Hey, I said stretch, not jump. Okay, their question is a galvanic cell a spontaneous or non-spontaneous reaction? That seems fairly easy. Probability of getting it right or wrong is 50%, because you can guess if you don't know. You can say spontaneous. If you also don't know, you can say non-spontaneous. Ah, we're done.
Next.
We're done.
It's spontaneous energy.
Spontaneous. You sure?
Spontaneous reaction.
Spontaneous reaction. So let me check. The answer is actually spontaneous reaction. And Team A is correct. And it's not spontaneous energy. It's spontaneous reaction. So what is happening right now? Aisha, lock the other foot. You know what they say? When in doubt, laugh. Or when in doubt, pout. Or when in doubt, pose. So you can jump hope. Very excited. So the question is, does a positive cell potential indicate a spontaneous or non-spontaneous reaction? If you want us to come to Mpumalanga, Limpopo, Cape Town, Durban, Umhlanga, Umlazi, Emily, hit us up on Twitter and also on Facebook, and maybe you can find us at your school, and you might be hope up there right now about to answer the question.
Spontaneous reaction.
So spontaneous reaction, show it to the camera. Let me make sure of the spelling. So spontaneous. One letter is missing, and it's an O. It's E-O-U-S, the reaction. But she was nearly there, you know, 95%. You'd have gotten your 2 marks. But because it doesn't have an O. So hope, should I put my hope in you?
Of course.
Let us see, spontaneous reaction. And your handwriting is actually, and the answer is correct for hope. It was correct here, but it's missing O, so I can't get it to the action. I'm sorry. In my lap, you know. Be a comrade in one position. So, before Hope Amuva chain his hands, both of them. Hey, Aisha is very excited. Hey, Hope! Jump to the next two. So, your next question is, in a galvanic cell, oxidation occurs at the anode or the cathode? Team A is in the lead. I've got a question. And if Team doesn't actually get this one right, it'll be bad because Team A will be the winners if they get this one correctly.
Anode.
Anode. Let us see. Okay. And then let us cross over to Pell. To see.
Anode.
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 Anode. Anode is the answer. So both teams are correct. So Team B. Already done with their notes. So at least, oh, I'm looking here again. Okay, no problem. What needs to happen right now? I'm going to hand over Hope her keys. She only has one lock to unlock. And then, as I count 3, 2, 1, you will start unlocking your team member, and I'll continue asking your question. Before we continue, jump into the next two. Finally, you're the king. Finally. So, in 3, 2, 1, start unlocking your team member, and your question is, what device is added to a galvanic cell to complete the circuit? Okay, you think that it's a what? Okay, the answer was correct, it's a salt bridge. But I'm just making the winner's footage. Okay, what's that?
Sarafina, how are you doing, Sarafina?
I'm so awesome.
So awesome?
Yeah.
You know what you remind me of immediately when you told me your name?
I don't know.
Sarafina, Sarafina, baby, you my number. Why?
No, it's old style.
You have a song about your name?
No.
I'm a
Sarah, not Sarafina.
Oh, you're not Sarafina?
Mm-hmm.
It's a certificate.
Sarah.
But your classmates call you Sarafina.
No.
Why are you denying?
No, lies, you No, I'm not lying. You are like Sarafina. I am Sarah.
So Sarah, what is your question for our teacher back in the studio?
How do you represent a reaction using cell notation?
Sarafina, but mina ngiyathanda igama la Sarafina bangokufa. But thank you for the question. So umbuzo goes like this. How do I represent the reaction using a sound notation? I just asked Kumilo Wuti, if you have an anode and you have a cathode, where is reduction and oxidation?
So I'm going to write a nationwide school. Then China's back and you saw again the seed line in oxygen. Which team A, we're victorious. Yeah! But I made a new friend, Pearl. She's my ninja. Ninja, ninja, ninja. Say Enoch again.
Enoch!
So do you understand the shout out to who have you read the
book? Oh, to my mom. Me, I get confined and I love her.
You love her. Like I learned to love you. Also love hearing from you guys on Twitter and also on Facebook. And you also get could bring a chance for us to come to your school and play awesome games like we did with these from students while I get a nationwide. Right now, it's time for me to love and leave them. But they should keep watching. What?
Guys, how y'all doing?
We're good, and you?
Good, thank you. There's a song that we're singing right before the show's on, right? Mm-hmm. Lean with it, rock with it. Come on, lean with it,
rock with it.
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 Innocence, how you doing, girl?
Good, and yourself?
I'm great. Now, tell me, who inspires you? Who's the South African celebrity who inspires you who's doing international things?
Bonang, she's a presenter in Top Billing.
Oh, yeah, Bonang Matheba! Shout out! She's actually also now the face of E! Entertainment in Africa. Did you know that?
Yeah, I know.
She's
that.
The face of Revlon! Yeah. What does she not do? Huh? She was nominated for a Nickelodeon Award. Miss T, did you know that?
Yeah.
Bonang, follow what
she
won.
Went, didn't she?
Did she even win?
I think she did win.
She's out here on Instagram with some easy living her life. Queen B. Nah?
Yeah.
Navy, how you doing, girl?
I'm good, myself.
I'm great. No, first of all, I'm fascinated by your name, Navy. Because you do know Rihanna's fans call the Navy, right?
Yeah.
Are you a Rihanna fan?
No.
You're not a Rihanna fan, but your name is Navy. Okay, well, first of all, is it because she's not South African, man? Does mean Heritage Month?
Yeah.
Is that why? You're like, nah, Rihanna, you're not South African. Sorry, you're not a fan. So tell me, which young South African inspires you?
Teddy Petal.
Oh, nice. Why? Why?
Cool, she's an actress, she acted on Utsozi and Gopalden the Beautiful.
Awesome stuff, man, and she's really doing great things as well. She was also the face of Revlon, and of course, like you said, Utsozi, so she's also really doing phenomenal things. I'm on Insta checking out all these celebrities. I'm on Insta like, oh, look who's making moves now. Because you guys are so awesome, you guys are winning yourself a math in that set, and then you send that math in class, ne? And your aunt? Why can't I get cheated so hard? Hey, swag, man. Hey, let's have a coffee like that, though. Like it. Okay, guys. So now the math that set is a set that helps stimulate visualization and helps young people also focus a lot. It works with graphs and so forth, and it's going to be helping them get really good marks because obviously, they're going to choose that mathematics, yeah, bonus. So yeah, you guys are working well with that. How awesome?
Good.
All right, now let's begin into the segment of the show that is called the Brain Breaker. And here we find out who gets the sarunga, but some of general knowledge in now. Do they know enough about the world around them? Okay, so question yamana ya Brain Breaker. Yeah, today goes something like this. Trevor Daniels was the first South African to host the American Daily Show. Is this true or is it false? Remember, you guys at home are also welcome to answer. Guys, what do you think? Was Trevor Daniels the first person to host the Daily Show in America? Is it true or false?
I think it's true.
You think it's true?
Yes.
Trevor Daniels?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yes.
Okay, Miss Susie, what do you think?
So I'm going to say no because wasn't that Trevor Noah, not Daniel?
Food for thought. Okay, let's see what the correct answer is. And the answer is false! The correct answer is indeed Trevor Noah. Trevor Noah joined the Daily Show in 2014 as a contributor. He made his US television debut in 2012 on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno and has also appeared on The Late Show with David Letterman, becoming the first South African stand-up comedian to appear on either late night show. Miss Susie, thank you. I'll see you ladies next time, eh? Next time. No, speaking of of our vandals are actually watching the interview I had Trevor Noah, and they asked him how he became a comedian, right? And he was like, he went to a stand-up comedy show with his cousins and them, and there was a comedian on stage, you know, doing his thing, but his cousins were drunk, so they booed the guy off stage. They're like, get off, because you're so whack, right? And the guy was like, well, if you guys are good, can one of you come on stage and do what I'm doing? And they were like, well, he can, and Trevor Noah had to stand up and literally go start. How awesome! And when the guy on stage, people were just laughing at what he was saying, so he's like, I was just talking, people started laughing.
Finally, we're going to have our lovely gentleman, Roger, with us in the studio. Guys, good? So I'm calling out, what's your name?
Lorraine Majorana.
And yourself, sir?
Lorraine.
Lorraine, tell me, what are some of your hobbies?
My hobbies... I want to be a presenter.
Oh, you want to be a presenter?
Yes.
Why do you want to become a presenter?
I want to... because I like to talk to people.
Mm. But you seem a little bit shy, though.
No, I'm not shy.
Is it?
Yes.
Still want to spark off a little bit.
Yes.
Alright, Nadi, do you think that it's important for young people to, you know, take an interest in politics?
Yeah.
Why do you think it's important?
Because they get to know about, you know, parliamental stuff, and they have to rise to vote.
Exactly. I just thought of running a bit like in my face. Just because you guys are so great, you guys are going to walk away with a metal man to sing.
They're chilling with us right here in studio, because Niasmos, without these gents, like, the show is boring. How you guys doing?
We're good. Always fine.
Always fine. I like that. Always positive. Ne?
Yeah,
sure. Sure, well, up to my girl and I have my friend, we're not even allowed to get money. Tell me a little bit about yourself.
Not to like a silly normal bunny. Get out of your town.
Alright.
Yeah.
And what do you like doing, Jay? Or chilling, like, if I'll buy?
No, I'm chilling, Jay. I like to play soccer.
Is it?
Yeah.
What position? Are you good, Mara, my friend?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm playing central defense.
Okay. Alright, so who else are we with? When I come on little love?
It's Dutuba Dube, but you can call me Kevin, as I've said. Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah, I live in Zola North. I do like music in my spare time because I'm an artist, you know.
What type of music, my friend?
Hip hop.
Yeah, right? You sound like a hip hop artist right there. Okay, so you're working hard on the music thing. Have you started working?
Yeah, I've started working. Hey, I need to release some tracks, you know. Busy in the studio every day, yeah.
Thank you so much, Jay. So these are the guys that we're going to be chilling with on today's show. And because they're so cool, they're going to be walking away with a super cool Method Match set. And you know what? The friends are also chilling with some lovely ladies. Now these are the VVIP. You guys are not just VVIP. You're all VVVVVIP. How are you guys doing?
Good,
I'm also alright. But you know what? It's not good to have friends, but you don't know about them. You don't know anything about them. So what's your name? Tell me about yourself.
Okay, my name is Precious and I'm cool girl class hyper active.
Is it?
Yeah.
Alright, yeah.
And I love sports, athletics, Jen.
What's your favorite sport?
Yeah, athletics.
Okay.
Running.
Yeah.
You look like a runner, Mara, right?
You look like a runner, I must say. Okay, so who were you chilling with? Well, who did you come with, Belen? I'm French.
Oh, mini kamala muno tano ngwenya, 11. I can't see Nia's cool male.
You always stand your ground.
Obviously.
Alright, so I want to find out from you, Belen, when you're done with the matric, what would you like to do?
Ish.
I heard you shop. There are so many options for you right there, lady. So you can think about it. You can be anything that you want to be. And you know what? Not just be anything that they want to be. They also get to get some really cool stuff from Michele Zanati right here. Now, ladies, because you're so awesome, you're going to be walking away with the map. Now, watch me wave. Watch me wave.
Yeah. medals, right? Number one, two, three.
Number four.
So which means when you're running, hey, we want the gold. Precious. Small Madonna, we want the gold.
Small Madonna.
Gold only. Then, so let's make sure when you are participating, make sure you have the school here at the back. Hey, boys, listen. You have the school here at your back, right? And see, just compare your uniform with others. It's the best uniform. It's for the best people, right? So you're going to get the best from you, right? Okay, so let's not go far. We'll be at one place, isn't it? So that when the events or maybe we're starting participating, you don't have problems. Are we clear?
Yes. Yes.
Wonderful people. Let's clap hands for ourselves.
Wonderful.
Nice.
It's a nationwide.